Tessa Rae Yoga.
Hello, lovely people. Today we are going to be doing a quick and delicious practice for people who work at their desk. You need a chair and a wall. Let's get started.
Okay, so we're gonna start sitting. You're sitting at your desk, you're slouching. So take a moment, sit up tall, lift your chest. Let's roll the shoulders back a few times. Big circles back. And as we're rolling the shoulders back, push into your feet, push into your sit bones. Find the middle of your sit bones and push down. Draw your belly back. And then we're gonna take our fingertips to our shoulders and we're gonna do a few big circles forward with our elbows. Think about your ears being lifted up and the top of your head being lifted up towards the ceiling. And we're gonna go backward circles. Pushing into the feet, pushing into the sit bones, drawing your belly back. Just nice deep breaths. Okay, and then we're gonna come and stand up behind the chair. Okay, so we're gonna come into the best chair stretch ever. So I'm taking my hands wide on the chair, like as wide as the shoulders is great. I'm gonna step my feet back and not step on my doggy. Bend your knees, pull the belly in and stretch your hands and your hips away from you and just take a few really deep breaths and just enjoy that opening that you're getting. Imagine that you can tuck your chin and lift the back of the skull up. Lean the hips away from the hands. Try to avoid arching the back, so really lift belly ribs away from the floor and sink into the armpits. Playing with a little bit of knee bending and pushing the floor away without locking the knees. And just holding. And then bending the knees, look towards your chair, walk towards your chair, come on up, pushing into your hands. And then we're gonna work with a little bit of breathing. So we're gonna inhale, arms wide, palms touch, hands overhead, exhale, hands into heart center. Inhale, arms wide, exhale, hands through. A few more times like that. Belly drawing in and just using this movement to open up the upper back and to just take some big breaths. Next time the hands come together, just roll out the wrists. Find a little bend in the knees, belly in. Try to press into your big toes and the outer heels of your feet. Let's go circles the other way. Keep the belly drawing back. Think about just engaging your glutes, your bum a little bit. And then letting your arms come down. So continuing to work with the breath. If you have a wall, that's my personal preference. I'm gonna use my hand at the wall. I'm gonna take my feet away from the wall, keeping my feet together. And I'm gonna inhale, exhale to lean my right arm or my outside arm in towards the wall. Inhale, the arm lowers. Exhale, lean. Belly in, inhale, lower. Exhale, lean. If you don't have a wall, just use your chair. I just do feet wide, knees bent. Inhale, reach. Exhale, lean. I like the wall so much better though. And do a few more. And leaning to hold, pressing that outer hip out, drawing the belly in and pushing the wall or chair away from you, lifting out of that shoulder. And bringing yourself up and then going for the other side. So feet together if you're using the wall. Push the wall away from you, inhale. Exhale, lean. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, lean. So again, feel free to use the chair, just legs wide and knees bent. Always core engaging. And next time you lean into the chair or wall, holding there, lifting out of that supporting shoulder, leaning the outer hip away. And bringing yourself up. And then using the chair, we're going to, just chair for balance there, we're gonna have our feet at hips width and we're gonna bend into the knees, push the floor away and lift the heels up. So you might not need the chair. Heels down, bend, push the floor away, lift the heels, lower the heels, bend, push, lift, lower. Just do that a few times, waking up your legs, really trying to press into the outer heels and big toes as you bend, bend, push, lift. Okay, from here, so probably needing the chair, we're gonna bend our knees, almost as if we're sitting in a chair. We're gonna hook the right ankle on the left thigh and press the right knee back and sit down into your imaginary chair. It is an option to just do this sitting, but you've been doing lots of that. So I find this is nice for activating the legs, opening the hip, belly drawing in. If you don't need the hands, don't use them. Really pressing that right ankle into the left thigh is gonna deepen your hip stretch. And then pushing to stand up, other side, bend the knees and hook left ankle on right thigh and sit down. Use your chair if you need for balance. Hooking that left ankle or kicking that left ankle into the right thigh. Draw the belly back and sit a little deeper. Draw your shoulder blades towards one another on your spine. And push into the floor to stand up. And then keeping the feet the hips width, let's bend the knees. Let's step our right foot back and straighten out your left leg. And we're just gonna get a nice hamstring stretch here, leaning over the left leg. Some of you might be quite flexible in this way. So then you could walk your hands down your chair as if it were like a ladder. Maybe you can even take your hands on the floor. Something we're being mindful about is that the pelvis is flat. So if you feel like you might be tilting here, just do your best to flatten it out. Engaging the kneecaps and lifting them up the thighs. Pressing again into big toes and outer heels of both feet. Walking your hands up your chair and stepping that back foot forward. Go ahead and swap your side. Step your left foot back. Find your straight spine and then hinge forward over that right leg and get that lovely leg stretch, hamstring stretch. And again, just do your best to see if you can square the hips. Pressing into the big toes, pressing into the outer heels. I'm thinking belly and ribs lifting away from my thigh. Kneecaps lifting up my legs, lengthening through the upper back, top of the head, skull sliding up. And walking your hands back up your chair just to assist you. Bend into your front knee and step that foot forward. Let's repeat our chair stretch, this time with the feet together. It's a little deeper into the sciatic nerve. We're stretching hips and hands away. Belly ribs lift away from the floor. A little bend of the knees is nice, and really just lean hips back. Think about sliding the skull up, a little tuck in the chin there. Strong core. Bending your knees and looking towards your chair. Come back up. Standing tall, roll the shoulders back. And then last thing we're gonna do, we're gonna sit back into the chair. Okay, so I just want you to become aware of your sit bones here on the chair. So we just do a little bit of pelvic tilting. So tilt the pelvis forward, tilt the pelvis back, still. So as you come onto the back, you can feel how you can really draw the core in. So definitely do that. And then consider that we have fronts of the sit bones, middle of the sit bones, and backs of the sit bones. Find the middle of your sit bones, and that's where we wanna stay seated. Now you're gonna turn sideways on your chair. I'm gonna actually turn my chair. You probably don't have to, so turn sideways on your chair. Turn to the right on your chair. Sitting tall. So you're sitting sideways on your chair, reach around for the back of your chair and do a nice assisted twist here. Try to stay on the middle of the sit bones, try to keep your core in, and then the right hand is gently pushing and the left hand is gently pulling. Draw the shoulders down and just take a few big breaths into the rib cage. This is one of my favorite chair stretches that I teach. It's just such a nice spinal twist. If it's comfortable for the neck, look over your back shoulder. Still feeling middle of the sit bones, belly in, both feet pressing into the floor, and then slowly unwinding. So now we're going to move the left sit bone off of your chair. Let your left knee drop and then quite strongly tilt the pelvis under. So almost like you're trying to come onto the backs of your sit bones here. And you'll start to feel a stretch through the front of the leg, which is great. Keep your belly lifting up. Make sure that you're not gonna tip your chair. We can take our left arm up beside the ear and reach. Really keep that tailbone tilt. And then we can stretch towards the back of the chair. Keep working that tailbone tilt and pressing into that left heel. Left thigh pressing back, such a beautiful stretch that gets into our quad, our hip flexor, our psoas muscle. And you just look with the head wherever's comfortable. I kind of like looking down. Quite an active stretch, keeping the core strong, keeping the tailbone tilting under. Leaning into that stretch. And bringing that top arm up and then coming out of that, turning around to face the other way on your chair. Find the middle of the sit bones, find your core, grow tall, reach around for the back of your chair. Now left hand pushing, right hand pulling. And breathe expansive breaths into your rib cage. Feeling the expansion evenly through front, back, and sides of the ribs. If it's comfortable for the neck, looking over the left shoulder. Think about how we rolled the shoulders back and down. See if you can find any of that movement here. Still on the middle of the sit bones, still with the belly back. And slowly unwinding. Get your right sit bone now off of the edge of the chair. Let the right knee fall down. Toes tucked if possible. Untucked is fine too. And we're gonna scoop under. We're gonna take our right arm up. Big breath in. Keep that scoop. And lean, if it's comfortable, over to the left. Lean towards the back of the chair. And again, you can look with your head wherever is comfortable for you. Keep working the tailbone tuck. Keep pressing that right knee towards the floor and maybe even back a little bit. And reaching with your top arm to come up. Bringing that foot down. Last thing here. We're gonna fold forward over the thighs, and you may choose to lift your bum up and like come into more of a forward fold. I want you to interlace your fingers behind your back and just stretch those hands away from your back and let your head dangle. And again, can be done seated. It's actually easier with your bum higher. And just careful, gentle, patient with this. Your shoulders are reaching away from your ears. We're working on doing our best, straightening out the elbows and getting the hands away from the back. If you've managed to interlace, take your hands back to your sacrum and swap the interlace. Swap your thumbs, pointers, rest of the fingers. And then just repeat that stretch. No effort in the head or neck here at all. And when that feels good for you, you can just bend your knees and come back and sit in your chair and go back to work.
I so hope that you enjoyed your practice today. If you did, please like this video. And if you'd like to continue to support free yoga on YouTube, consider subscribing to this channel. If you want to be really popular around the office, why don't you share it with everybody, all of your coworkers, all of your friends? Thank you so much for joining me today and allowing me to share my practice with you. Namaste.